Hi guys, welcome back to Edu Ed channel. Today we will be discussing the brief course outline of veterinary pharmacology and toxicology in MSVE 2016 curriculum. So veterinary pharmacology is actually a branch of pharmacology that deals with the study of drugs, how drugs act on the body, how drugs origin, what are the chemical composition, what is the action with the body, how are they eliminated inside the body, what are the physiopathological effects they produce, what are the pharmacological actions of the drug, what are the biochemical and physiological effect on the drug, how it is absorbed, how it is distributed, how it is cleaved into different parts and excreted, and the concentration of plasma, and various things we will be studying. We'll be dealing with many other drugs which are used in only in veterinary and which are both used in veterinary and human medicine. So this is the brief outline of veterinary pharmacology. So in MSVE 2016, the course credit is 4 plus 1, that is 5. There will be having, in a week, we will be having 4 theory classes and 1 practical classes. 6 units are present, and these are the marking structure for the annual examination. And 20 marks, this is 80, and 20 will be taken from the internal examination. So moving to the unit 1, which is in the theory, general pharmacology. Mainly, it deals with the introduction, history, development, branches of, and scopes of pharmacology, source, nature of drugs, etc. Then pharmacodynamics and pharmacokinetics. In pharmacodynamics, we will be dealing with the receptor, the concept of drug-receptor relation, dose response, drug interactions, adverse drug reactions, etc. And pharmacokinetics, we'll be dealing with the study of administration, absorption, distribution of drug, biotransformation, excretion, that is ADME. We'll be mainly dealing with ADME. So, a nomenclature of drugs, many pharmacological terms and definitions, all we'll be dealing with unit 1. Moving to unit 2, drugs acting on autonomic nervous system. Here, we'll be dealing with the neurohumoral transmission, that is transmission of nerve impulse. The main neurotransmitters in the autonomic nervous system, the divisions of autonomic nervous system, that is sympathetic system and parasympathetic system. In sympathetic system, we will be dealing with sympathetic agonist and sympathetic antagonist. In parasympathetic system, we will be dealing with agonist and antagonist. And mainly, we will be dealing with the autocoids, that is the internally produced bodies or drugs or elements that can act as drug. That may be like histamine, histamine analogs, antihistaminics, then serotonin, agonist, antagonist, eicosanoids, platelet activating factors, angiotensin, bradykinin, and kallidin. We'll be dealing with these autocoids detailedly. Now the drug, unit 3, will be acting, drugs acting on the central nervous system. So here what we'll be using, the main drugs acting on central nervous system will be studied. That is mainly classification of drugs acting on CNS and special type of neural humoral transmission in the CNS. And we'll be dealing with the anesthesia. In anesthesia, we'll be dealing with history, mechanism, stages of general anesthesia, local anesthesia, and mainly general anesthetics and local anesthetic and dissociative anesthetics. Also, we'll be dealing with inhalant and intravenous and dissociative anesthetics. And moving to the other parts, we'll be dealing with hypnotics, sedatives, and anxiolytics, psychotropic drugs, anticonvulsants, that are drugs which decrease the convulsion, and the opioid analgesics, which relieves the pain, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, which are known as NSAIDs, analeptics, that is respiratory stimulants, and other CNS stimulants. And we'll be dealing with antidepressive drugs, anti-epileptic drugs, anti-convulsant drugs, that both are the same, and anti-psychotic drugs, which are used in darting, also in sedatives, etc. Now, in drugs acting on somatic nervous system, that is the muscle nervous system, we'll be dealing with local anesthetics, muscle relaxants, and euthanizing agents. So moving to the unit 4, which is drugs acting on different body system or the systemic pharmacology. Mainly, we'll be converting drugs into four out of different systems. So we'll be dealing with digestive system, cardiovascular system, respiratory system, urogenital system, skin system, pharmacology of fluid therapy, etc. In digestive system, we'll be dealing with stomach aches, which increase the stomach activity, and acids, which decrease the extra secretion of hydrochloric acid, anti-ulcers, prokinetics, carminti, antipsychotics, antizymotics, antiemetics, which prevent the omission, purgatives. And moving to the cardiovascular system, we'll be dealing with the cardiotonics, hematopoietic drug which help in RBC formation, cardiac stimulants which help in stimulation of the cardiac muscle, antiarrhythmic drugs which are used to treat arrhythmias, antihypertensive drugs used to treat hypertension, and anticoagulants and coagulants. Now moving to respiratory system, mainly we will be dealing with expectorants and antitussives, which prevents excessive production of mucus and coughs, respiratory stimulants, that is anaphylaxis, which increase the respiratory rate, bronchodilators, which are used in asthma, and mucolytics, which are used in excess mucus production. And moving to the drugs used in urogenital system, diuretics, mucolytics, exabolics, etc. Now moving to the unit 5, veterinary chemotherapy, which is a little bit large unit in veterinary pharmacology. So we'll be dealing with the introduction, historical development of chemotherapy. Then moving to the antimicrobial agents. What are antimicrobial agents? What are its therapies? What are general principles? And what are antibiotics? So the main antibiotics we'll be dealing with are sulfonamides, penicillin, cephalosporins, cefamycins, beta-lactamase inhibitors, aminoglycosides, aminocyclic toluenes, quinolones, furoquinolones, polypeptides, glycopeptide, macrolides, amphenicols. And we'll be dealing with the miscellaneous agents, that is lincosamides, novobiosin, virginiamycin, thiamulin, nitrofurans, and methylamine. So the next drugs used in veterinary chemotherapy mainly deals with antitubercular drugs, antifungal drugs, which will be topical and systemic, antiviral, anti-cancer drugs, anthelminthics, antiprotozoals, ectoparasites, antiseptics and disinfectants. We'll be dealing with the difference between antiseptic and disinfectants and main antiseptics and disinfectant used in veterinary field. Then the pharmacology of drug abuse of animals. Then the indigenous medicinal plants pharmacology. There are many indigenous plants which has got many medicinal value, and they are used in many pharmacological actions to decrease any of the problems happening in the field. So we'll be dealing with many of the plants. So moving to the last unit, but the very important unit in veterinary pharmacology and toxicology is the veterinary toxicology. This is the last unit, unit 6. We'll be dealing with the history of toxicology, toxics. There are many toxicants produced by the plants, other animals, and other poisoning agents. So we'll be dealing with these all things, and we'll be dealing with the antidote. So we'll be dealing with toxicity caused by metals and non-metals whenever the animals intake more amount of metals or non-metals. Or whenever they are grazing, they will be taking poisonous plants. How to manage it? Toxicity caused by agrochemicals. Whenever the animals are going to the ground and for grazing, there will be many agrochemicals over there, so it can cause many problems. So we'll be dealing with the problems created by the insecticides, chlorinated hydrocarbons, rodenticides, etc., and how to cope up with the situation. So the fungal and bacterial toxins, animals will be usually having these toxins inside them whenever they are grazing and browsing, etc. So the venomous bites, animals may often will get the venomous bites or stings from the nature. So we have to be careful with this snake, scorpion, spider, bees, etc. They'll be having many toxins, and we have to give antitoxins. So concept of radiation hazards, environmental pollutants, etc. We'll be dealing with this. So in practical parts, there are only 5 units. That is general pharmacology. Mainly we'll be dealing with handling and washing of laboratory wares, concept of good laboratory practices, and pharmaceutical dosage and prescription writing, etc. In NS pharmacology, mainly deal with the action of autonomic agents, that is autonomic agonist and antagonist, how are they acting, and we'll be dealing with the simulation experiments. CNS also will be acting with simulation experiments, handling of lab animals, and regulatory guidelines for use of ligands. In veterinary chemotherapy, we'll be using demonstration of various chemotherapy agents and their dosage forms. We'll be also testing the antibiotic sensitivity through Kirby-Boyer test and other tests. In veterinary toxicology, demonstration of toxic weeds and plants of local area, detection of heavy metals or non-metals, plant poisons, agrochemical toxicity, antidote therapy via simulation methods, and also methods of calculation of median lethal dose or maximum tolerated dose. Thank you. If you guys want to look on the books used for veterinary pharmacology and toxicology, I have done a separate video for the books used in veterinary practice and veterinary science studies. So you can view that video. I'll be giving the link in the description box.